Shiv Vishwanathan, you are someone who admittedly was little skeptical, in fact very skeptical, of how well Aam Aadmi Party would be able to govern Delhi. In your initial assessment, do you think that they still haven't managed to leave the gimmickry behind and get on with governance?
Actually, there's no gimmickry. What you're seeing is an experiment. And you're seeing an experiment where a party in all its transparency is enacting out democracy. It makes mistakes, it looks foolish, in fact it's almost naive, but its ability to react in a healthy way to these mistakes is far superior to anything the BJP or the Congress has done. Look, there's a limit of the comic, there's a great sense of small mistakes, but in a deep and fundamental sense, this is democracy and governance in a new and experimental way. Making mistakes can't be lethal in this context. I think they're transparent, you're seeing people respond, and in fact I see people respond very confidently to them, with a confidence they never had in the BJP and the Congress.
And that is a very important point, Sambit Patra. You seem to be more worried because some of these experiments might have backfired on the Aam Aadmi Party, but plenty of them have worked as well. So every time you counter them with criticism, well, there have been a few hiccups, and the Aam Aadmi Party has been honest. Arvind Kejriwal said, "I'm sorry, I should have thought through the Janta Darbar. It did not work out so well. So, well, here is the alternative. We are going to have helplines instead." So, why are you being so cynical? At least give them a chance. At least they are trying. You can't fault them for not.
No, they have a chance. They have a chance. They are trying, and we are not stopping them from trying. The most important issue is, look, we are not frightened, as you're trying to paint over here that the BJP is frightened. No, we are prepared, we are not frightened, but the most important part is we are trying to expose the truth over here, and that is what democracy is all about. Look, I mean, coming to a lighter note, I have personally been saying that it was an abusing and accusing party prior to the government election over here in Delhi, but now it appears, thanks to the TV channels also, it is acting, advertising and publicity. Well,
of these things which you dismiss as gimmicks, you know, when Manish Sisodia went to these night shelters on 31st of December, you said, "Oh, what gimmickry." Now we have Shivraj Singh Chauhan doing the same things. So you try and deride them, but then try and do the same things yourself.
Padmaja, tell me, is it that Mr. Shivraj Singh Chauhan became the chief minister of Madhya Pradesh for 3 times just because at the fag end now he followed what Mr. Kejriwal did? Or in fact, Mr. Kejriwal and others tried to do what the other chief minister had been doing?
When was the last time he went to a night shelter?
Why not?
When did he last go?
I do not have the dates over here.
Because he didn't.
No, these are trivialities. These are not details required.
Is it? Then why did
but
he
the detail
go on that
is,
inspection?
No, I tell you, the detail is he had been working for the ones who are downtrodden, who needed the machinery to function for them. That is the result as to why he has been time and again elected to the post where he's sitting on. Just gimmickry would not have sufficed.
Okay, Rahul Mehra of the Aam Aadmi Party also with us. We're sorry he could not join us right at the beginning of the debate. Rahul Mehra, essentially just to bring you up to date with what we've been talking about, is whether the Aam Aadmi Party has got well-intentioned schemes, but they're not really being thought through. Would you concede that maybe more thought needs to be given to a lot of these schemes before they're actually implemented? For example, the Janta Darbar?
Well, you know, we are a party which has just come into power hardly 2 weeks back. And, you know, if you look at it, what is it that we have done? I can give you a list of things that we have already, in a short-term measure, we have already provided. And, you know, based on the commitments that we've made on our manifesto, huge deliverables have already been delivered. Now, people can obviously, you know, dissect those, and that's the liberty that they have, and try and find faults in it. I would only say, look at the issue of water, electricity, DISCOMs being audits being allowed and having been undertaken.
Which
when
is fair,
we were told
and we
that
give
audits,
all of that to you. But what about
CAG?
The things that haven't quite worked out? Things like the law minister calling the district court judges for a meeting, the fact that it was alleged that a few ministers in the Aam Aadmi Party cabinet were throwing their weight around, the fact that there is still so much yo-yoing as far as the house for Mr. Kejriwal is concerned, the Janta Darbar being another example. What about all of that? Because people start to doubt whether they've really made a wise choice, whether they've put the reins of Delhi into very inexperienced hands, Rahul Mehra.
I don't think it's a cause of concern for the people. I think it's more a cause of concern for the opposition political parties and the political party which under the veil of whatever compulsions that they had, they were forced to give us an outside support. These are the people who are insecure. I don't think people of Delhi, if you please, by all means, go out to the people and find out, even with the inexperience or the the kind of Janta Darbar that we held.
Okay.
Were they happy that the chief minister was engaging with the people? So yes, you can understand that methodologies can change, and we are a responsive government.
But can we afford to let them learn on the job because it could have been dangerous, Rahul Mehra. Sambit Patra wants to rebut.
No, first and foremost, why do...
Just let me complete my thought, please. Allow me to complete.
Okay, go ahead.
Allow me to just make one more point. Thank you. What I'm saying is, what was the Janta Darbar? Now, what we have done is, rather than people coming to, the Chief Minister and the Secretariat, we are saying we will embrace technology, and we have already put in a mechanism where even people who are not technologically friendly, they also have call centers where they can just call up and they can give their complaints in detail, which will be reproduced, and measures will be taken.
So
technology is going to be used. Number two, Arvind is going to get to people. So he's going to go out to Vidhan Sabhas, and he's going to, rather than people coming to him, Arvind is going to go to people.